A number of users have reported poor multicolor print quality on the Prusa XL. This is in line with what we found in our previous video. After much experimentation, we've come up with a solution.
With just a small change to the gcode, we can drastically improve multicolor print quality on the Prusa XL. Although the tool changing on the Prusa XL is really cool, we noticed a lot of stringing and blobbing whenever the printer changed extruders.
Before every tool change, the bed drops down to prevent any collisions with the printed objects.
The problem is, lowering the bed often results in this spiky string of filament getting left behind on the print. This extra material attaches to the nozzle of the next extruder that's used, accumulating over time into a blobby mess. These blobs of excess plastic then fall off in random places on the print, resulting in unwanted artifacts.
We tried increasing the retraction and reducing the nozzle temperature. After implementing these changes, print quality was slightly improved, but neither of these solved the problem. This is not surprising since this spiky string is specific to the tool changing and it's not something we see on single color prints.
Why don't we just modify the way the printer carries out the tool changing?
That's a good idea, but the tool changing motions are encoded by firmware, so we can't change that unless we want to edit the firmware of the printer. But there is a workaround. We can move the nozzle off the print before we initiate the tool change.
Oh, that's perfect! That should prevent the nozzle from leaving a vertical string on the print. But how do we tell the printer to make a movement like that?
If we look at the gcode in the print preview, we can see that there is a line called filament-specific and gcode right before every tool change. We can directly edit this line if we go to Filament Settings, Custom G-Code, End G-Code. Make sure the program is set to Expert Mode, otherwise you won't be able to access this area.
So, to make the extruder move to the back of the printer, all we have to do is add this code.
G1 means that this line encodes a movement. This part here tells the extruder to move all the way to the back of the printer to position Y equals 360 millimeters. E-1 tells the extruder to retract the filament 1 millimeter. The F command sets the speed. We'll put a large number here so that the printer will quickly carry out these movements.
Essentially, this line tells the printer to move the extruder away from the print and retract the filament before initiating the tool change. Just in case, you should make sure your prime tower won't be in the path of this movement.
Since this change was made in the filament settings, you'll need to make sure that this modified filament profile is selected for each extruder.
Of course, you should also make sure your filament is dry. That's always important.
Now let's see if this fixes our problem.
Wow, look at that! No more defects. The prints look great. Let us know in the comments if this fix works for you.
See you next time on 3D Print Dogs.